Good evening and welcome to a very interesting panel discussion on spirituality and education. And sometimes when we think these two worlds of spirituality and education seem to be poles apart, but very closely interlinked. And to discuss this, it's a pleasure to have some of the most respected names in higher education from India having a discussion with Rishi Nitya Pragyaji. I'll introduce all the speakers and then we'll have some opening remarks by Rishiji, followed by comments by each of our speakers, and then we can have an interaction. Rishiji is the director of programs at Art of Living, one of the world's largest non-profit organization. He is a trained chemical engineer, and after having worked in the corporate environment, he chose to become a spiritual seeker. He has taught meditation and spiritual wisdom to more than a million people all over the world. He has also taught spirituality at places like FRCC, TISS Mumbai, IITs, IIMs, the London School of Economics, and has spoken at more than 70 universities. His recent book, Celebrating Life, published by Penguin, became a bestseller on spiritual wisdom. So we are glad to have you here, Rishiji, and please guide us on this topic. We have Professor Raj Kumar, who is the founding vice chancellor of O.P. Jindal Global University, which also recently received the Institute of Eminence tag from the Government of India. He's a Rhodes Scholar, has studied at Oxford and Harvard from a legal background. I'm also proud that he was my teacher when I was a student of the Jindal Global University. So welcome, Professor Raj Kumar, to this discussion. We have Vineet Guptaji, who is the founder and trustee of Ashoka University, as well as Plaksha University, two very promising and highly respected names in the field of education in India. He is the founder of Jambori Education and did his undergraduate education in engineering from IIT Delhi. And again, I'm very proud to have him as a senior all of us look up to in the IIT Delhi fraternity. Welcome, Vineetji. Professor Rupamanjari Ghoshji is the Vice Chancellor of Shiv Nawdhar University. Having a background in physics, she studied at University of Calcutta and did her PhD from the University of Rochester. She spent a lot of years at the Jawaharlal Nehru University before joining the Shiv Nawdhar University. And Shiv Nawdhar University also received the Institute of Eminence tag by the Government of India. Welcome, Professor Ghosh. When we were planning this event and I was talking to Professor Rajkumar, he said that he's not into spirituality much, but I think what all three of you as higher education leaders, what you are doing is actually Karma Yoga. And I think you're very, very much into spirituality. But what's the relevance of spirituality on education? I'll request Rishiji to throw some light on it and then all of us can respond. Rishiji, please.
सबसे पहले मेरा तीनों को चारों को बहुत हृदय से नमन प्रणाम. मुझे ऐसा लगता है स्पिरिचुअलिटी का जो बेसिस है ना वो यही है कि हर इंडिविजुअल सोल के अंदर हर जीव के अंदर जो एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी पावर्स दिए हुए हैं बनाने वाले ने सच फैंटास्टिक एबिलिटीज हैव बीन बेस्टोड ऑन ईच वन ऑफ अस each individual by the nature. Uska in-depth exploration is the basis of spirituality. I feel, mujhe ek event yaad hai, toh us event se main shuru karunga. We had organized a huge event in London where Gurudev Shri Shri Ravi Shankar ji had come and addressed a huge crowd in Wembley Concert Hall. And after the concert got over, we had a satsang there. The interviewer of BBC TV had come to interview Gurudev. And after many back and forth question answers, I remember one question that the interviewer asked Gurudev. That Gurudev, you have, Shishi, you have millions of devotees world over. How do you feel? So I remember Gurudev very promptly responded. He said, I have not come here to make devotees. I have come here to invoke that godliness, that divine spark, which is already there in each individual. I have come here to invoke that spark. And that touched my heart, that stayed with me still today. It is my driving force. Main dekhta hun, har individual शक्तियों का भंडार है, जिस इन शक्तियों को अंदर की ताकतों को है ना अपने शास्त्रों में सिद्धि कहा है. देयर आर 16 टाइप्स ऑफ सिद्धिज, यू नो, फ्यूचर जान लेना या किसी का मन पढ़ लेना या बिफोर समथिंग हैपन्स यू नो सेंसिंग इट, जिसको हम इंट्यूशन कहते हैं. दीज आर ऑल वेरी नेचुरल, वेरी कॉमन हैपनिंग्स एज फार एज द ब्लॉसमिंग ऑफ द कॉन्शियसनेस इज कंसर्न. मोर ब्लॉसम्ड द कॉन्शियसनेस इज ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल सोल, मोर सिद्धिज आर अवेलेबल टू देम. नाउ अपना जीवन अगर हम देखते हैं ना, तो मुझे लगता है 6 डिफरेंट सेक्शंस वाला जीवन है. मैं थोड़ा सा डिटेल में जा रहा हूँ, प्लीज मुझे एक बार खुल के सुन लीजिएगा. 6 सेक्शंस हैं जीवन के, ऐसा समझ में आता है. एक तो है संबंधों की दुनिया है, रिलेशनशिप्स फील्ड है. सेकेंड वन इज द प्रोफेशन, वेयर यू नो अर्थार्जन हैपन्स, या नौकरी हो या बिजनेस हो, ये सेकेंड फील्ड है मनुष्य जीवन का. तीसरा है हॉबीज, किसी को लिखने की हॉबी है, किसी को गाने की है, किसी को क्रिकेट की है. द हॉबी फील्ड इज द थर्ड फील्ड ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइफ. द फोर्थ वन इज द मेंटेनेंस एंड यू नो सस्टेनेंस ऑफ रोबस्ट फिजिकल हेल्थ. वो एकदम अलग फील्ड है, संबंधों की दुनिया अलग है, रिलेशनशिप प्रोफेशन का फील्ड अलग है, हॉबीज का फील्ड एकदम अलग है. चौथा है फिजिकल हेल्थ बनाए रखने की बात. द फिफ्थ फील्ड मैं कहता हूं सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज है हमारी, द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ऑफ ए रिस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन, आई वुड से. जैसे एक सिटीजन की तरह, एक मामा चाचा, एक फ्रेंड की तरह, सोसाइटल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज का एक पांचवा फील्ड है अपना. एंड द सिक्स्थ फील्ड आई फील इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वन, इज द स्पिरिचुअल ग्रोथ वाला फील्ड, जिसमें मैं 2 स्टेप्स देखता हूं सर. एक है नेगेटिव टू न्यूट्रल का और दूसरा है न्यूट्रल टू पॉजिटिव का. माने इंडिविजुअली हम अपनी नेगेटिविटीज को, अपने शॉर्टकमिंग्स को, अपने अंदर के त्रुटियों को हम पहचाने और उसमें से मुक्त होने का एक उपाय सोचते रहें. ये पहला स्टेप हुआ नेगेटिव टू न्यूट्रल का. हार्मफुल टेंडेंसीज में से फ्रीडम होती जाए, वो पहला स्टेप है नेगेटिव टू न्यूट्रल का. एंड द सेकेंड स्टेप, मोर इंपॉर्टेंट देन द फर्स्ट वन आई फील, इज न्यूट्रल टू पॉजिटिव का स्टेप, जिसमें अंदर की जो ब्यूटिफुल ताकतें हैं, सिद्धियां हैं, उसको ब्लॉसम करने का एक जिम्मेदारी है इंसान का. जैसे संबंधों की दुनिया में मेंटेनिंग द ब्यूटिफिकेशन ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन कॉन्शियसनेस, सेम वे प्रोफेशन में सक्सेसफुल होना बहुत जरूरी है, वैसे ही फिजिकल हेल्थ बनाए रखना जरूरी है. सेम वे अंदर के ब्यूटिफिकेशन का एक प्रयत्न चलता रहे, वो भी उतना ही इम्पोर्टेंट लगता है. अगर आप लोगों का मन हो तो मैं है ना, मैं उसके बारे में बात करूंगा कभी थोड़ा सा डिटेल में, कि जैसे ये जो 6 फील्ड्स है ना, संबंधों को सुंदर बनाए रखने के लिए अलग स्किल सेट चाहिए होगा, जबकि प्रोफेशनली सक्सेसफुल होने के लिए स्किल सेट अलग होगा. फिजिकल हेल्थ को बनाए रखने के लिए एकदम अलग गाइडलाइंस होंगी, डूज एंड डोंट्स होंगे, जबकि सोशली रिस्पॉन्सिबल बनने के तरीके एकदम अलग होंगे. द सिक्स्थ वन आई एम सेइंग स्पिरिचुअल ग्रोथ का जो फील्ड है, उसमें जैसे भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने हमें 4 योग दिए थे ना, कर्मयोग, भक्ति योग, ज्ञान योग और ध्यान योग, इनके द्वारा फुल ब्लॉसमिंग ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल सोल इज वेरी इजीली पॉसिबल. वो एक कंप्लीटली अलग फील्ड है. तो मैं ये कहता हूं एजुकेशन में, जिसको हम शिक्षण कहते हैं, एजुकेशन कहते हैं, उसमें इन सभी क्षेत्रों का ब्लॉसमिंग शुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द एजुकेशन सिस्टम. दैट इज वेयर स्पिरिचुअलिटी कैन कम इन. द मोर मैं उसको है ना एक स्वाध्याय का क्षेत्र कहता हूं. एक छोटा इंट्रोडक्शन दूंगा इसका. जीवन को अगर देखेंगे, सब सुन रहे हैं ना मेरी जीवन को अगर देखें तो ये मोमेंट बाय मोमेंट बाय मोमेंट बाय मोमेंट जीवन का फ्लो चल रहा है ना. इस फ्लो ऑफ लाइफ में एवरी मोमेंट आप देखें तो 2 विभागों वाला जीवन नजर आता है. वन इज योर आउटर वर्ल्ड एंड द सेकेंड वन इज योर इनर वर्ल्ड. अच्छा, आउटर वर्ल्ड जो है वो व्यक्ति, वस्तु और परिस्थिति से बना हुआ है. पीपल, things and situations are making the outer world. Whereas your inner world is made up of man, buddhi, chitta aur ahankar. Mind, intellect, memory and ego. In char se aapki andar ki duniya bani. Achha, mera point ye hai, moment by moment by moment life mein, व्यक्ति वस्तु परिस्थिति वाली बाहर की दुनिया आपकी अंदर की दुनिया पर असर करती रहती है ना, वैसे ही आपकी अंदर की दुनिया में जो भाव जगते हैं, जो फ्लेवर्स जगते हैं, वो आपकी बाहर की दुनिया पर भी उसी तरह का इंपैक्ट करते रहते हैं। नाउ ये जो स्पिरिचुअल एजुकेशन का जो फील्ड है ना, उसमें मैं ये कहता हूं, यू मे नॉट हैव टू मच ऑफ कंट्रोल ओवर व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द आउटर वर्ल्ड, हाउ द पीपल आर, हाउ सिचुएशंस गेट क्रिएटेड, what things are around you, you may not have too much of control over them. But to be able to control your inner world, to be able to maintain beauty and harmony and enthusiasm and love and beautiful flavors in your inner world, isko main swa adhyay kehta hu. Recognizing your own strengths and weaknesses, to be able to drop your weaknesses, to be able to enhance your strengths, beautification of your inner world, is what the basis of spirituality is. And once you learn to do all that, ye chhe kshetron wala apna jeevan aur beautify karke jee lena is not a very big job, it's not a very big deal, is what my experience has been for last 27-28 years that I am with Gurudev Shishi Ravishankar ji. And that is what I feel the crux of spirituality is, which should be a part of education system, and that is why I have come here in front of you today. Was it too long, Sahil?
thank you for that background, Rishiji, because this makes a lot of sense when we look at our students or when we look at ourselves and we try to think of what best we can do, you know, for our community. I think this can form an essential component of you know, a complete student life or student development. I'll request our speakers. We can start with you, Professor Raj. Your remarks or your experiences on this topic.
Yeah, thank you very much, Sahil, and of course, Rishi Wood University for really hosting a very important panel discussion. Such a pleasure and deeply inspiring to hear Rishi's very profound words. In some ways, for many of us who are broadly in the field of academia, a lot of emphasis is always placed upon our constant endeavor to discover the truth. To be able to constantly working towards, finding the truth, and to have, and mostly to seek purpose and also evidence for that truth. And this remains a constant discovery and exploration for academics across different disciplines. In those who are in the field of sciences in particular, be it in STEM disciplines and medicine and others, this is a constant effort to provide that scientific backing for, having that truth to be discovered. And with those of us who are working in social sciences, it's equally important for that discovery of truth, but it is also, relevant for being able to speak truth to power. And that remains a constant goal. But in all of this, I think one of the things that gets lost is the deeper purpose and meaning that is attached to the very, objective of seeking education, or for that matter, pursuing the discovery of truth. And it is in that context, I believe, that spirituality and education becomes important, because in many ways, serving humanity is the greatest form of spiritual journey one can undertake. And what it does in any educational pursuit is that it prepares, human beings, particularly young people, to be able to pursue their fullest potential in the path of both self-discovery on the one hand and social transformation on the other. Mahatma Gandhi pursued that path so powerfully when he talked about the need for spirituality as humanity. Also, many other social reformers who were part of the freedom movement were very conscious and very comfortable with the idea of pursuing spirituality on the one hand and also pursuing the path of social transformation on the other. So in some ways, I think it's important for us as educators to recognize this and impart this thinking among our young people. I believe modernism has a very strong space for spirituality, and we need to not only acquire that space, but even at times snatch that space from being hijacked by different forces that at times misinterpret and misguide and even undermine the larger purpose of education, which includes inner transformation on the one hand and social transformation on the other.
Fantastically said, sir. Very well said.
That's so wonderful, Professor Raj, because you know, I think even if you look at some of the most admired philosophers in the field of education, whether it is whether we take inspiration from Swami Vivekanand or Sri Aurobindo or Jiddu Krishnamurti, they were deeply spiritual, and this pursuit of truth, inner truth as well as social good, was at core of their work. So you're absolutely right that this should also become the thinking in the current times in our educational system. Vinidji, I want to come to you because you have studied engineering from IIT, and then you have set up a very prominent liberal arts university. Now you're also setting up a technology university. Where do you feel and find spirituality having a relevance in your work?
Well, thank you, Sahil. And Rishiji, it was wonderful to hear you. And I think the way you outlined the six dimensions in which our life operates was very profound. And I think while we intuitively think about these six dimensions, I think you laid them out very clearly, and it was very, very profound listening to you. Professor Rajkumar has always sort of outlined where academia is, what scientific pursuit of knowledge is, where social sciences are concentrated. India has had a long tradition with spirituality and education sort of being intertwined. If you look at our universities, right from Nalanda, Takshashila, then Professor Rajkumar spoke of Swami Vivekananda Aurobindo. So in some sense, our traditional higher education has been intertwined. And the growth of the human being, the inner self, as Swamiji said, in some sense has been intertwined with intellectual growth and pursuit of knowledge. Mm-hmm. However, I should say that higher education, as we know it in the last 70 years, and I had the privilege of studying at IIT Delhi, which is one of India's premier institutions, I think a lot of our tradition of the last 70 years in higher education has been very Western based. And a lot of our universities, institutions, whether it's engineering, whether it's sciences, whether it's social sciences, that tradition has taken some form or has been adapted in some manner from what has happened in Western universities. And I do feel very strongly that somewhere the Indian tradition that we have, where spirituality and education were intertwined, it is missing. I mean, I would start by acknowledging that, right? Mm-hmm. And I do feel that universities in the modern world have this first goal of imparting knowledge, new knowledge, creation of new knowledge, imparting knowledge. Secondly, they also end up imparting key skills. Mm-hmm. And now there is this notion that universities also need to develop attitude, right? And within that broad goal of attitude, really going beyond yourself, contributing to public service, dealing with failure. And I think there are various aspects of attitude which even the modern world realizes is key to success in life, is key to covering your inner meaning. And in some sense, what I wanted to say is that even in modern higher education, this notion of spirituality is coming full circle, and there is great recognition that as we impart knowledge, as we impart skills, there is greater need to even develop the emotional quotient, the spiritual quotient of each youngster to help them discover their potential.
Well said, yes.
this is now coming back into education in various ways. Yes. You know, at Ashoka, for example, we run a center for well-being where our psychologists would use the term progressive relaxation. And when I delve deeper, I discovered it's another term for meditation, right? So there are these scientific terms. Life is coming full circle, and this whole training on spirituality, helping you discover your own potential, going beyond your own self, contributing to humanity, is coming back in academia through various ways. But I should again say that in universities like ours, or even some of our top institutions, the meanings and notions are still in a Western context. And Rishiji, my question to you also would be, and it is also a question, it is also a prayer in some sense. How do we bring in greater notions of this Indian tradition and thought, which is extremely rich, into mainstream university education? And the challenge, I'm not been an academic and a scholar like Raj and Rupa, but I have watched and built institutions a little bit from the side. And often this journey to navigate spirituality and academic thought, doesn't happen very comfortably and automatically. And I think onus is on both sides, on academia and leaders in higher education and the leaders of this great Indian tradition to come together and see how this can come more and more in education. I mean, clearly there is a need. I feel somewhere our education is incomplete if these notions don't come in. So I do look forward to the day where we can bring this very rich and powerful tradition into mainstream higher education. So I'll stop by saying here, but delighted to meet you, Swamiji.
Absolutely. Vinit ji, main aapko ye kehna chah raha hu abhi ki apne paas hai na Gurudev ke saath main 27-28 saal se juda hu. Gurudev ne jis tarah se ek curriculum diya hai, किसी को जैसे सपोज इन द फील्ड ऑफ फिजिक्स और मैथमेटिक्स और केमिस्ट्री, किसी को अगर ग्रेजुएशन करके वहां रुकना हो तो वो भी कर सकते हैं, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन करना हो तो वो भी कर सकते हैं, पीएचडी लेवल तक जाना हो तो वो भी अवेलेबल है. एग्जैक्टली लाइक दैट, अंदर की खूबियों को, अंदर की ताकतों को ब्लॉसम करते हुए एक समष्टि के कल्याण का पात्र बनना, एक एक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन का इंस्ट्रूमेंट बन के जीने का, अगर किसी को एक लत लग गई, किसी को अगर एक स्पार्क जग गया मन में, तो उनके ट्रेनिंग के लिए पूरा का पूरा कैरिकुलम है अपने पास. यानी अगर किसी को अपना अपना ही मन संभाल लेना है, अपना जीवन सुखमय जी लेना है, तो उसके लिए भी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम है. किसी को अगर एक छोटे से लेवल पर एक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन का साधन बन के जीना है, तो उसके लिए भी एक फॉर्मूला अवेलेबल है, एक करिकुलम अवेलेबल है. मैं कहता हूं, किसी को मोक्ष प्राप्ति में इंटरेस्ट है, अपनी फुल ब्लॉसमिंग 16 की 16 कलाओं को कंप्लीट ब्लॉसम करके जीवन जीना है, वो करिकुलम भी अपने पास अवेलेबल है. एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरली रिच हेरिटेज इज वेटिंग टू बी एक्सप्लोर्ड सर. और आप लोगों के पास इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं, आप लोगों के पास बच्चे हैं. मैं कहता हूं, मैं जिसको रिप्रेजेंट करता हूं उस ट्रेडिशन के पास, उन बच्चों के कंप्लीट ब्लॉसमिंग का, कंप्लीट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन का फॉर्मूला है. अगर हम सब लोग साथ में मिलकर कुछ कर लें, तो मुझे लगता है स्काई इज द लिमिट, स्पेस इज द लिमिट. मैं एक्साइटेड हूं उसके बारे
में. यस ऋषि जी, नो वी शुड सर्टेनली प्लान दैट. एंड द यूनिवर्सिटीज व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट हियर टुडे ऑन पैनल, दे आर रियली रीडिफाइनिंग द फेस ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. एंड इट विल बी सो वंडरफुल टू डिस्कस दिस आइडिया एंड टेक इट फर्दर विद ऑल ऑफ देम. ऋषि, यू रेज सम वेरी इंट्रीगिंग पॉइंट्स. आई थिंक इट्स एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट व्हेन यू सेड दैट we should start by acknowledging that there is something that that we have missed in our in our mission to modernize and improve our education system. We have become Western, and there is a lot of heritage, there is a lot of value.
Sorry, that I'm thoda sa kar raha hu yahan, बट ये है ना, ये बाय एक्सीडेंट नहीं हुआ है सर, ये बाय डिजाइन हुआ है। यानी अपनी एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी रिच ट्रेडिशन को तोड़ने का डिजाइन बना के तोड़ा गया है उसको। तो हमें लगता है थोड़ा सा और मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी उसको री एस्टैब्लिश करने के लिए।
एंड ऋषि जी, उसकी जिम्मेवारी भी मुझे लगता है दोनों तरफ रहेगी, तो आपसे और बात करेंगे डिटेल में।
यस यस, विनीत जी अच्छे लेवल पर लेकर जा सकेंगे, मैं रूपा जी को सुनने के लिए उत्सुक हूँ। प्लीज प्लीज
यस रूपा जी प्लीज।
I'm sorry, Rupa ji, मैं आपको आपका थोड़ा सा
it's been fascinating. You know, I often get, I remind myself of this quote that speak only if it improves upon the silence. So I was thinking of this, that why do I want to actually come to this forum, because I may not have much to offer, but I think it was, for me, it was a chance to thinking aloud and more learning, listening to all of you. So I'll say why I am saying this. So it may not be totally relevant now that I listen to all four of you. Spiritualism for me is primarily an individual pursuit.
Yes.
And that's the way, right? From childhood, that's the way I've been brought up. I also then read a lot, and then I'll call somebody religious who understands the suffering of others. You know, this is action-packed Mahatma Gandhi. But essentially, that was what religion and spiritualism was for me. But later on, of course, I've understood that spirituality involves essentially a recognition of a feeling or a sense. You know, I don't know, maybe it's a belief that there is something greater than myself, something more to being human than sensory experience, exactly what you are talking about, and that the greater whole of which we are part of is something cosmic in nature. So essentially, for me, it meant an opening of the heart. That was an essential aspect of spirituality for me. It helped my science. You know, to be always be looking out for something that's not in me, but using experimental tools. I did something in quantum mechanics that you probably know. They are not day-to-day experience. They defy logic, commonsensical logic. I had to devise experiments, and my experiment actually started a trend. But nobody believed me, actually. When I was first talking about it, even my own supervisor, it's now a famous paper, but he did not believe me. So I had to do the theory, then I did the experiment. And the process was as step by step as my spirituality. You know, it's like always prepared for something bigger, but go through it in the logic that you have been taught. So I think that was important, that, you know, I've got a brain as a gift, and I'm actually using it to its fullest potential. So the topic today drew me to say yes, to again think aloud and mainly to learn. And there is a reason. From that individual spiritualism, today we are talking about some kind of an alignment for an institution, right? So it's a collective good, and the alignment of purposes that defines maybe the culture of the institution. And I think that's where, as a head of the institution, I have immense respect for this, to learn what is it that you can align for the institution to go. So even if you have five different beliefs, like five strong horses, pulling your institution in five different directions, that does not work. It works for those five individual horses, but for an institution, it doesn't quite work. So you have to have some kind of an alignment and then experiment with that. So in science research, Raj has put it nicely, but you know, I often talk about it. I actually do not see any conflict between science and religion, or science or belief. Because there are many things that we do, we shelter under, by something that I call scientific methodology. That defines the shell. You can't question science because it defines itself in a very logical structure within that methodology. If you break down matter from molecules to atoms to finally, in hydrogen atom, people said, okay, there are electrons and on, and there's a nucleus, and that's what it is. Then you hammer it down, and nucleus also is something. So the question comes, who created all of this? I mean, where have I come from? Where am I going? This question, science sort of keeps it out of its domain. The whatever you cannot really test in an experiment, in a logical fashion, it keeps it out of it, and it keeps on pushing the frontier of knowledge to encompass more and more. So learning through analyzing religion as an important expression of human experience is one part of what Raj was talking about. And I'm talking about science, and then I'm talking about the expression of human experience, learn about and from the beliefs, values, practices, traditions, and viewpoints that could be even independent of religion. So I think that's really is important for me. For me, in a nutshell, spirituality in education refers to a deep connection between a student, a teacher, and the subject. And the connection is so honest, so vital, and so vibrant that it cannot help but be intensely relevant. In some way, in its true form, I'm already practicing spirituality at that grand scale, because, you know, it's an honest relationship, and that's the best form of spirituality as we can see. On the functional part at SNU, like Vinith was mentioning, we also have a wellness center, and in the academic program, everything rests on a very deep network of advisors at various levels. So you take care of the young minds. But I think it's necessary probably to not leave it at the individual level, and not just at the outside structure level that we do, but to handhold the people who already have the experience and maybe get into this, because it's very important that we do not just create people with skills, but we create people, ultimate thing would be happiness. Are they being happy in life? And in some way, for me, what has worked is it's my faith. My faith is bigger than my fears. And so I think that has saved me. And I think I can't talk like you. I you know, I also am part of FICCI. And there we get Gurudev to talk to us often. Yeah, and I co-chair the FICCI Higher Education Committee. So I see that, and we learn. Only thing that keeps me going is that faith that I know. That I have that faith. So I think from these individual expressions, if you can get the collective, it will do our youth immense good. And I think in some way, spirituality in education for me is already this deep connection that exists and must exist and has to be intensely relevant. So thank you for organizing this panel. Thank you.
Thank you.
कुछ कहने का मन हो रहा है मुझे, मैं कहूँ?
Yes, yes, Rishi ji, please.
Raj ji. Vinit ji.
Yes.
You know, मेरे पास, मैं खुल के बात करूँगा, थोड़ा सा रिस्क लेके भी, थोड़ा let me be very honest and open with you. कभी है ना एक दूसरे के साथ बैठ के ये इनर ब्लॉसमिंग का जो प्रोसेस है उसका जो निटिग्रिटी है, उसका जो मेथोडोलॉजी है, उसका जो अपने पास करिकुलम है, मैं सचमुच ये चाहता हूं आप सब लोग एक बार वो करिकुलम खुद एक्सपीरियंस कर लें. आपके अनुभव के बाद आपको अगर ये लगे कि अरे ये बहुत वैल्यूएबल हो सकता है अपने बच्चों के लिए, स्टूडेंट्स के लिए, जिन लोगों को अपने अंदर की पर्सनल कॉन्शियसनेस को डिवाइन कॉन्शियसनेस के साथ मर्ज करने में या फुल ब्लॉसमिंग में जिनको इंटरेस्ट है, उन लोगों को एक करिकुलम मिले और उसके लिए अपने पास जो जो तरीके हैं, जो टेक्निक्स हैं, वो अगर कहीं हेल्पफुल हो सके ना, आई विल बी द हैप्पीएस्ट. मेरे जीवन में जो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन किया है उन टेक्निक्स ने, और जो मैं होता हुआ देख रहा हूं दुनिया भर में, लोग अपनी अपनी इच्छा से आते हैं कोर्सेस में एंड मैजिकल एक्सपीरियंस लेकर वापस जाते हैं, उनके जीवन की पूरी क्वालिटी बदलती है. इफ दैट ट्रांसफॉर्मेटिव वे ऑफ लाइफ कैन बिकम ए पार्ट ऑफ एजुकेशन सिस्टम, आई कांट टेल यू हाउ हैप्पी आई विल बी. एंड जैसे रूपा दीदी कह रहे थे कि फाइनली इट बॉयल्स डाउन टू हैप्पीनेस. अच्छा, अपने शास्त्रों में उस हैप्पीनेस के, उस ब्लिस के भी ना अलग अलग फ्लेवर्स बताए हैं. आपने शायद ये सुना हो कि भगवान श्री कृष्ण, he had all the 16 facets, 16 कलाएं fully blossomed in him. वो क्या क्या 16 कलाएं हैं? तो जैसे वीर रस है जो वैलर का फ्लेवर है, दूसरा है करुणा रस जैसे कंपैशन है, तीसरा है माधुर्य, किसी की चेतना में किसी की कॉन्शियसनेस आप देखोगे यू रियली फील दे आर सच स्वीट पीपल, तो माधुर्य है उनके अंदर. किसी के अंदर ऐश्वर्य वाला भाव दिखेगा, दे लुक वेरी रॉयल, दे लुक वेरी यू नो जैसे मैग्नानिमस दिखाई देते हैं. ये अलग अलग फ्लेवर वाली अपनी हर एक व्यक्ति की चेतना है, और उन सभी फ्लेवर्स को, ऐसे 16 फ्लेवर्स हैं, 16 फ्लेवर्स ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस, उन 16 के 16 फ्लेवर्स को ब्लॉसम किया जा सकता है, उसका टेक्नोलॉजी है. And that is what I feel we have available to us. तो मैं कहता हूँ जैसे professionally successful होना जरूरी है, relationship सुंदरता से maintain रखना जरूरी है, physical health ठीक से रखना जरूरी है, वैसे ही मैं कहता हूँ before we drop this body, आप जैसा अपना मन बनाना चाहते हैं, the kind of mind that you want to create for yourself, अंदर की दुनिया जिस flavors वाली बनाना चाहते हैं, उसका भी training वेरी इजिली पॉसिबल है. मैं ये कह रहा हूँ, सो बिफोर वी ड्रॉप दिस बॉडी, यूटिलाइजिंग दिस ह्यूमन बर्थ, यूटिलाइजिंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ बीइंग इन द ह्यूमन फॉर्म. आप देखो तो नेचर में ह्यूमन लाइफ जितना, ह्यूमन फॉर्म जितना इवॉल्व्ड, न्यूरो सिस्टम कहो या एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम कहो, इतने इवॉल्व्ड सिस्टम्स और किसी प्राणी के पास नहीं है. ये जो ह्यूमन बर्थ मिला है, उसका ऑप्टिमम यूटिलाइजेशन करने का अगर करिकुलम मिल सके अपने बच्चों को, तो मजा आ जाएगा.
That was yeah, Rishi. I mean, that is this sort of an ambition is so exciting, and it can give us a drive for entire life.
Yeah. I'll just want to add something.
Ask all the speakers to give their comments. I want to comment on Professor Ghosh's address. I think so. Professor Ghosh, forgive me for saying this, but I think you had a wrong conception that you can't add value to this discussion, because what you shared it enriched the discussion a lot, and I think the concept of truth and its its unification between, whether we call it science or spirituality or whatever, it's one truth. It can't be two truths. So thank you for bringing that perspective to the panel. Professor Raj, you were saying something. Sorry to cut you off.
No problem, Sahil. Now, I wanted to, Shiti, I wanted to mention the fact that most of the time when we are in higher education institutions, we are engaging with young people who have already been, their values, their perspectives, their worldviews, their basic foundational approach towards life, yes, to a large extent has been established. And yes, so I've always maintained that this discourse and discussion that we're having, we need to push it stronger to primary and secondary education. And that's where much of this transformation needs to happen. I'm not abdicating the responsibility of the higher education institutions, but essentially a lot has already become very strong and deeply embedded in the mindset of young people who end up coming into higher education, that our ability to seek fundamental transformation of an approach or a worldview becomes even more limited. And that's something which we need to, and that's why we need to engage not just as a society, but even higher education institutions need to engage with schools and colleges. And one of the things that we have tried to do within our university is to build, set up establishment opportunities in the form of Center for Spirituality and Mindfulness and learning that happens and transcend beyond the classes and the coursework that a student undertakes.
Yes, yes. And you know, Rasab, main ek aur cheez dekhta hun. I get an opportunity of teaching meditation and this Art of Living programs to really all classes of people, where young students also join and housewives also come, and presidents of the countries to Bollywood and Hollywood stars, to everybody. You know, I really feel so blessed that I get an opportunity of connecting with huge range of people. In all these people, I have noticed one fantastic thing. कि जैसे ही कोई चीज मैं ऑफर करता हूं ना, कार्मिकली जो रेडी हुआ सोल है ना, वो नेचुरली ग्रेविटेट कर लेता है सर. और जो कार्मिकली रेडी नहीं होता, उसको हम कितना भी शुगर कोटेड करके और जिस इतना भी फैंटास्टिक पैकेज बना के उनके सामने रखते हैं, इट जस्ट सिंपली डजंट वर्क. सो मुझे कई बार ये लगता है मेरा जो काम है ना, वो जैसे इंडियन आइडल्स में वो टैलेंट सर्च का काम लगता है. आई एम रियली लुकिंग फॉर पीपल हु आर ऑलरेडी इंक्लाइंड टुवर्ड्स फाइंडिंग देयर ओन डिविनिटी विद इन, यू नो. तो वो जो प्रोसेस है, वो जैसे हायर एजुकेशन का आपका जो पॉइंट था कि उस लेवल में भी वैसे ही कुछ लोग मिलेंगे जो ग्रेजुएशन लेवल पे भी मिलेंगे, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन लेवल पे भी मिलेंगे. हमें उस बात को सेंसिटिव रखते हुए ही, सेंसिटिव रहते हुए ही हमें फॉर्मूलाज ऑफर करने होंगे लोगों को, इक्वेशंस ऑफर करने होंगे. सब आई फुली अग्री विथ यू. मैं कई बार ये कहता हूँ कि एक लीटर दूध उबालने के लिए रखते हैं ना सर, तो मलाई 50 ग्राम ही निकलती है, और हमें तो उस मलाई में रस है.
I think you sort of touched upon the point I was raising. Sahil, I think, did not understand it. What I was saying is, for me, it's an individual quest, right? I mean, it's an individual. It's actually, it's in my being. So to make that community thing, I mean, you as a guru, some people will accept, come to you, some will understand. Yeah. Absolutely. Education institutions have a different purpose. That's the point I was making, Sahil. You did not understand. These things have their own places, right? I mean, when you come to the university, the way you do it, we are doing it. It's not like I'm not doing it, but I'm doing it in a many very subtle form as a day-to-day existence way. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing it as a curriculum that you are talking about. I have not gone through it, so I'll definitely look at it. But we have not done it so far. I mean, I think I don't see the need almost for that, because I feel it has to be inside. I mean, but I suppose you do need, it's not my case, it's actually everybody's case, that you probably need this in a collective way. But I'm not sure universities are the, I mean, Rishiyur definitely is. I wouldn't have come here, Sahil, if when Professor Vansal asked me, and I really wanted to participate, but it's more for me than in an institutional way, because I'm not capable of seeing that. That is the point. But I think you sort of answered partly what you said, and I know your ways, but I'm still debating whether my institutional form is the right form. It can be the baseline, I mean, I suppose, but I think it has to be done in a way that I don't need another curriculum. I need curriculum. These are much more transactional. Yours is much more all-pervasive, you know. It's existential almost, right? So there has to be a difference between the two. And I'm speaking a little early because I wanted not to speak on this, because I wanted to read what you have and then only comment. And that makes me very curious today. So what I always considered an individual pursuit, to bring it to this collective form.
Rupa Didi, will you please give me an opportunity where I can take you through some very, very beautiful experience first? Is that okay?
Yes, I'll be blessed.
That will be wonderful. Raj sahab, aap kuch keh rahe the. Sorry.
Vinit was saying something.
Vinit bhaiya,
Rishi ji, I wanted to make two quick points. You know, I did mention that, you know, in academia today, especially amongst the student body, and there is a tons of literature coming out from universities abroad. I mean, there is this famous book by Professor Angela Duckworth at UPenn who writes, you know, she's written this book called Grit. But this really, this need for developing mindset and attitude in students, because there is a belief that without mindset and attitude, you know, your career or your progression could be limited, right? Then there is this whole notion, what is coming up, this whole notion of authentic leadership, right? And if you see great leaders, I mean, great leaders are spiritually very evolved and powerful, at least a lot of them. So the point I wanted to make is that at least in some of our universities, these notions of developing mindset, developing authentic leadership are coming in and are coming in strongly. But they are coming in from a very, you know, from Western literature. And when you go deep, you realize that some of it is extremely common to our strong Indian tradition. And some of the strong Indian tradition we have is actually missing in some of that literature. So that's the first point. There is a need. The second point I wanted to make is that, and I'm being very honest, just like you've been very honest, that the moment the conversation comes about spirituality, somewhere it also gets mingled with religion. And in academic institutions, quality higher educational institutions, you know, ultimately curriculum is offered which has the alignment of faculty. And often on the issue of religion, it's not easy to align all faculty and people will have different voices. And I know your work, I know I have, at least I've not practiced fully, but I've been a part of some Art of Living seminar and they have very little to do with religion. But the point I wanted to make is the more and more we can keep religion out of it and craft programs in a manner which seem very neutral and not affiliated, the greater will be the acceptance and the greater will be the speed with which they can come into institutions.
Vinit ji, aap mere dil ki baat bol rahe. You know, maine personally, अबू धाबी से, दुबई से लेके, बहरीन से लेके, वहां पर भी कोर्सेज कराए हैं मैंने, और हम कम्प्लीटली रिलीजन को आउट रखते हैं उसके अंदर. हम ना हम ओम बोलते हैं वहां, ना यू नो, वी डेलिबरेटली कीप इट वेरी वेरी साइंटिफिक. स्पिरिचुअल ट्रेनिंग को भी बहुत ही साइंटिफिक एस्पेक्ट देते हैं. मैंने जो बुक लिखा है, आई विल गिफ्ट दैट बुक टू यू थ्रू साहिल जी, सो आप एक बार वो पढ़ें. मैंने उसका, उसके अंदर भी स्पेसिफिक मेंशन यही किया है कि ह्यूमननेस को एक्सप्लोर करने के लिए हमें किसी रिलीजन की जरूरत नहीं है. मैंने उसको ये इस तरह से देखा है कि रिलीजन इज लाइक ए बनाना स्किन, वेयर इज द स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज द बनाना. वी डोंट नीड टू होल्ड ऑन टू द स्किन्स, वी कैन रियली बी अवे विथ इट एंड focus on the banana itself. So what you are saying is very correct, sir. और हम इस तरह से उसका, आप सब लोग एक बार अनुभव करें, उसके बाद इस तरह से उसका पैकेज बनाएंगे किसी को भी उसको एक्सेप्ट करने में कोई तकलीफ ना हो, उस तरह से बना सकते हैं पैकेज, कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है.
I think it was a wonderful discussion. I had not expected that so much would come out from this discussion. There was a lot to learn, because I see all four of you as role models, and I think all the students, the entire Indian student fraternity is looking up to people like you, and this discussion would be very inspiring for them. If there are any final comments by any four of you, we can take them and then we can close this discussion.
I want to reflect a bit on what Vinit has mentioned. I think I appreciate the fact that Vinit's concerns are quite genuine, and it's an important aspect that we all have in universities. But it's also equally important for at least a country like India, which has not only given birth to, but has had such huge civilizational heritage when it comes to so many religions. It's important for us to have a deeper discourse on religion itself. Yes. I think there's a need for, major religions of the world. I can't believe the most influential and impactful scholars on some of the major religions of the world are not necessarily from India. And so there is a case for developing schools of divinity and religion and in a much more broader manner, completely conscious of the inherent challenges associated with it. I think it becomes very, I would say, intellectually dishonest for us to shy away from religion, and one can actually study religion in all its deep formulations and forms and manifestations, including its philosophical foundations, even without being actually wedded to any particular religion. Such ought to be the power of the intellectual discourse that need to prevail in our society. And I think there is a case for building that culture. Now, of course, we are also conscious of the fact that it does have those risks that Vineet mentioned. But I, for one, do believe that Indian history and civilization and educational evolution for over several thousand years should be able to argue and debate and deliberate on those issues.
Yes. That's very true, Professor Raj, because when we look at some of the top universities in the West, a divinity school is a very core component of those universities. And I think in India also, we need to understand religion much more deeply rather than ignoring it. So in the academic world, I think there's a lot of vacuum where which needs to be filled up when it comes to study of religion. So thanks for raising that point.
It's actually, since that I mentioned that the learning through analyzing religion as an important expression of human experience, learn about and from the beliefs, values, practices, and traditional viewpoints, that's also independent of religious belief. And yes. I think that, like you mentioned, Sahil, that what I mentioned actually was I was talking about India. You are right that there are schools like this all over, and Raj is saying the same thing. We did not practice, but I hinted at that. This is precisely what I had in mind, what Raj is saying. I think this needs, because that's part of our job. There's a lot of learning there. I mean, you can see that. So I think that also has to go parallel. But that's different. I think that's more about understanding ourselves, even in the outside world. I mean, I think we need to understand those practices, learn from those values, the values that those religions brought to this country. So I think, yes, I also feel that's very important.
Yes.
Yeah. Suddenly it has gone dark where I'm sitting. So I'll request Rishi if there is something else that you want to say. Otherwise, I wanted to invite Disha Didi also to.
Please, Disha Didi say that.
Ji. So we have Dr. Disha Bhanushali from Rishiji's team. She is a maxillofacial surgeon, and I'll request her to share briefly about Rishiji's upcoming Delhi visit and how we can take this further.
Sure, Sahil. First of all, thank you, Sahil, for bringing this fantastic, enriching session today. Vineet ji, Rupa ji, Professor Raj, it was, and Rishi ji, of course, it was a wonderful evening. And, it reminded me of the days when I got introduced to spirituality. It was my first year of medical school that spirituality came into my life. And I, as a student, benefited tremendously out of the art of living techniques that I learned then. So, all of you all have been talking largely about spirituality, education, and religion. I remember one statement that came across through somebody who came to enroll me. That person said, we teach how to breathe. Everywhere you've learned how to walk, how to talk, how to, you're learning how to treat patients. We teach how to breathe. And that has got nothing to do with religion and neither to do with age. Nothing to, everybody breathes. So breathing and how to know your mind and know your breath is what the statement was. So I represent Art of Living, and whatever Gurudev has formed, the fantastic techniques and programs that Art of Living has to offer, I'll definitely be available with Sahil to do whatever coordination is required to bring these programs in whatever specific ways. It helps in your particular respective institutions. It would be an honor to pass on what we've got through Guruji.
I'm so happy I got this opportunity of connecting with you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Wonderful discussion. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.